Let me start the session. Yesterday we did only the introduction part. The actual training will start from today, and I'll open the notes, and the same notes you will find in the mail as well as the hard copy with the classroom people. So you can find out page number 1 and chapter 1. So let me start the training. So in today's session we'll complete chapter 1. So chapter 1 is the introduction, what we learn, the same thing quickly I'll repeat, and we'll also discuss the applicant and standard societies, okay, in chapter 1, which is again introduction part. So I think you remember yesterday we already learned what is HVAC. It's a heating, ventilating and air conditioning, and you know ASHRAE. Already we discussed American Society of Heating, Refrigeration and Air Conditioning Engineers, and we also this heating, ventilating, air conditioning. But apart from this, some more additional information in the notes. Yesterday we discussed the standard temperature for SUR, for human comfort, is 76. Okay, similarly the standard temperature for winter we are considering 72. So how we got this, the reference you can find out on screen. On the left side of the screen you can find out a human comfort standard, and below that you'll find ASHRAE comfort zone chart. Okay, and this chart is taken from ASHRAE handbook 2001, or if you refer 2017 also you'll find the same chart, and this chart is a part of from psychometry. And if you don't know psychometry, don't worry, we have it chapter 4. In chapter 4 we'll discuss in detail about the psychometry. Okay. So this part is taken from the psychometry, and this 60, 65 up to 90, this is the drival temperature, and this line, this curved line represent ASHRAE. Drival temperature, nothing but temperature. The normal temperature we used to call drival temperature. So here you can find out the reference, winter and summer. You can see the hatching, and in between the combined hatching, this will cover winter as well as summer. So if you talk about winter, the temperature, you see the temperature range is almost 68 to 76. So here you can find out 68 to 76. In between we are considering standard as 72 for designing point of view. If you take less than 72 up to 68, more than 72 up to 76 also accepted. In this range 68 76, 72 we are considering standard for calculation. Similarly, if you talk about summer, you see the summer hatching start from here up to this point. So this is 74 to around 81. Okay. So or 82. So you can find out the same 74 to 82. In between we are considering 76 as standard temperature. Okay. And in US mostly they are designing with 74. 74 also in the range. In some region they are designing with 75. That is also okay. And this standard temperature we are considering for multiple occupancy. Means, for example, if you're designing one person room, like a manager room or a director room, etc., as per his requirement we can design the required temperature. But this standard temperature we can consider for multiple occupancy, for example open office. So we cannot design in open office, for example, 50 people are working. I think you can understand open office with the cubicles. So 50 people means we cannot maintain the required temperature as per individual requirement. So in that case we are considering this as a standard. Similarly, if you are designing classroom, in the classroom you will find multiple students, so it is difficult to maintain the standard temperature as per the individual requirement. So we are considering this as a standard. So here you see, so I think what the standard question, and it may ask in interview. Suppose if you say 76 degrees centigrade, Fahrenheit, not centigrade, is the standard temperature, then if they may ask the reference. So the reference is ASHRAE comfort zone chart. Okay. Next. So I think remember we already discussed what is heating. Quickly let me repeat this. Heating is the process of adding heat in an internal space, the temperature less than what? The standard temperature, and already we discussed standard temperature, say 25 degrees centigrade or 76 degree Fahrenheit, by using what? Electrical resistance heater, boiler, furnace, etc. How to provide, don't worry, we have a topic we'll discuss at the time of types of machines, machine selection, etc. At this level why to provide. So normally, you know, in Western countries, most of the time heating is required because the temperature is very less. Like in, if you talk about UK, -5 or -10. In Canada, you know, when -20, less than -20 also. So even in Gulf also, for 1 or 2 months, we required the heating. Or in some hill stations also we required heating. In India also, like in Jammu Kashmir or even in New Delhi, in winter the temperature is very less, so we required the heating. Next, we already discussed about ventilation. So quickly, ventilation is what? Providing fresh air, and already we discussed in detail in yesterday's session. Next, air conditioning, you know the definition, and as per ASHRAE, so air conditioning is what? Maintaining the parameters. What are those parameters? You know, temperature, relative humidity, cleanliness, motion and distribution of air and noise level. So today, I'm reading this because already we discussed this in detail in yesterday's session. If next application, for example, if you talk about application of air conditioning, so any one example, classroom of air conditioning, where air conditioning is used, any one example. Residential, okay. Online, commercial means like office, hospital, etc. Yes, online, any one application for air conditioning. It's like hospital, like supermarket. The list will continue. Okay, so here the application is divided into two category. The first is human comfort category, and second is a process control. For example, if you design an air conditioning system, and if the prime concern is human, means human comfort, then we can consider that as a human comfort category. Like you can read here, residential buildings, offices, hotels, supermarket, hospital, classroom, the list will continue. Okay, so in this area, prime concern is human comfort. And if you design air conditioning for process, for a machine, because you see, nowadays we are dealing with the different process, different machines, with electronics. Maximum machines work with the electronic circuit, and it will work, means in order to get the efficiency, the electronic will control, and you know, electronic required a particular temperature to work efficiently. And even we amend the temperature to the machines to increase the life of the machine, to decrease the wear and tear, to dissipate the heat, etc. So in almost all the application in process control, maintaining the temperature is required. So if you design air conditioning for a particular machine, for a particular process, that comes under process control. Some examples are given here, like textile machines, photographic process, CNC as a mechanical, you know, computer numerical control machine, and clean rooms. One example of clean room is kitchen or medicine area. That area is clean room, or preparing this Intel motherboards. So if you talk about clean room, in clean room we are providing 100% fresh and clean air with a laminar flow. We have different categories or different types of classroom also, but generally clean room means 100% fresh air with no return, directly complete exhaust with a laminar flow. Okay, similarly in hospital, pathological lab, MR rooms, operation theater, even food processing. Actually, food processing belongs to refrigeration side, but the base or the basic of air conditioning is from refrigeration. So this frozen foods also comes under this process control. Okay, so the mainly the air conditioning application is divided into human comfort and process control. Apart from this, you will find automobile air conditioning, like car AC, like this vegetable, this truck AC. So you'll find automobile side also. Next, we'll talk about the standard societies. Yesterday we talked about the society, the difference between a society and a company. So society deals with the research and development for the particular area, and dealing with the survey and dealing and creating the course and standards, and that course and standard will follow at the time of design. So you'll find the list of societies here in the notes. The first is ASHRAE, you know, already discussed. So at the time of designing, HVAC system will follow ASHRAE standard. Similarly, if you're in India, we have a local society, ISHRAE, belongs to India. Next, we have SMACNA. SMACNA is important for ducting site, and we asked in interview also. SMACNA is what? Sheet Metal and Air Conditioning Contractors National Association. This society also belongs to US. They are also dealing with the research and development for ducting site. and like duct designing, duct installation, duct drafting, etc. All these courses standard you can find in Cigna handbook. Okay, and internationally accepted. And in interview also this is important. If they talk about the ducting side, duct design, etc., this MACNA will they may ask which standard you follow in your previous job or in your training, etc. So this is important. Next, DW144. This is also one standard used in Europe on some areas or some as per the project requirement. DW is what ductwork. 144 is a section given to the ductwork. Similarly, you'll find a different section for different components. Next, we have IS, Indian standards. So if you're dealing with the projects here, we are following ISRAE and IS. Next, ARI. ARI is what? Air Conditioning and Refrigeration Institute. So this society, or AHRI, this society deals with the what? Research and development for air conditioning equipments. You see, ASHRAE is for system designing. ASHRAE code is for system designing, but ARI is for equipment standard. For example, if you purchase a air conditioning machine and in that machine if you find the ARI logo, it means that machine is approved by ARI, internationally accepted. Like for example, Kirin machine, Daikin machine, Voltas, etc. If you get this ARI logo, means that is standard and internationally accepted. So if you talk about air conditioning machines, standard will follow this ARI. Next, ASTM. This is also important. When we talk about the material standard, not only for HVAC, it can be for other services also. So ASTM is the American Society of Testing Materials. So they are dealing with the research and development for material. For example, I think, you know, for vapor compression cycle, I think as a mechanical, you know, vapor compression cycle. But if you don't know, don't worry. We designed this course from the basic to advanced level. So if you don't know vapor compression cycle, we'll discuss chapter 3, which is very basic to understand the types of system. But those who don't know, as a mechanical, I believe, you know, this vapor compression cycle, like compressor, condenser, expansion, evaporator. And I think, you know, all these components are connected with the, which pipe, which metal of pipe? Copper, right? So how we come to know copper is good for that particular application? Similarly, you see, that is one example. Similarly, when we are dealing with the ducting, we are using GI. When we are dealing with the chill water piping, we are using black steel or mild steel, etc. So this information is based on the research and development by AST. And when we are dealing with the standard project, we are following the metal from AST, means AST approved. Like for example, copper pipe M88 is a code by ASTM to the copper pipe for that particular application. So you'll find the different standards for different metal for different application. So when we talk about the material, we'll follow the ASTM standards. Next, if you're working in UK, because you know UK people don't want to follow US standards, right? Because they have their own monopoly. So if you are working in UK for their local project, UK local project, so mostly you may find or you may use CIPSE. What is CIPSE? Chartered Institute of Building Services Engineers. It's a UK standard. But again in UK, for many projects, they are following ASHRAE also. But as per their country standard, you need to follow the CIPSE. So similarly, CIPSE is not only for HVAC. CIPSE is for complete building services, like CIPSE guide E for firefighting, CIPSE guide A for HVAC, etc. You'll find different guides you see for different services. So it's a UK standard. Next, if you're working in Dubai, actually DEWA is for water and electricity department. For HV standards, you may find DM. You can make a note here, DM, Dubai Municipal. Especially for ventilation standards, you need to follow the DM, Dubai Municipal. So as per the location, you'll find the different course, like for Qatar, you see Qatar Kharama, it's municipal. Next, RC, Royal Commission, if you're working in Saudi for Jubail, Yambo or Al Khobar region, you need to follow this RC, Royal Commission standard, Royal Commission course. Next, point number 12, 13 and 14. This three society belongs to green building. Okay, so before dealing with this societies, we'll talk about what is green building first. Okay, so green building information find in page number 4. I think most of the people know this because nowadays people are talking about green buildings, saving of energy, saving of environment, etc. So if you don't know, don't worry, I'll explain here. So what is green building? Any idea? Online or classroom? Green building. So it's very simple. Green building means the color of the building is green, right? The concept of green building is to save the environment, to save the earth, the major concept. But as a HVAC engineer, your responsibility to reduce the power consumption by power consumption means from the equipment, means HVAC equipments. Why? Because I think you remember, really we learn HVAC equipments will consume 60 to 65% of total electrical energy of the building. In remaining 40% of that electrical energy will be used by the lighting appliances of the building. So the major part of the electrical consumption by HVAC equipments. And how this is related to this power consumption and green building. So as I said, the concept of green building is to save the environment. And saving the environment means the major issue in today's world is CO2, carbon dioxide, greenhouse effect, different emissions, etc. So here if you talk about the generation of carbon dioxide, CO2, so I think you know CO2 will generate with the generation of electrical energy using fossil fuels like coal, like nuclear, like different fuels, etc. And that this electrical energy we are considering as a high grade energy produced with the low grade energy like fossil fuels, coal, etc. And whenever the electrical energy produced with this non-renewable energies like fossil fuels, CO2 will generate per kilowatt of electrical energy, some amount of carbon dioxide will generate. Okay, so the idea is, as a HVAC engineer, if you design your system with the maximum efficiency for your building and the same follow all the buildings in the entire city or in the entire country, what will happen? The total power consumption will reduce. And if the total power consumption reduces, I'm talking about electrical energy, if the total power consumption reduces means the generation will reduce. And if the generation reduces, the generation of CO2 will reduce. Or else we have other option. We can also use natural resources like solar energy, like geothermal, like wind turbines, hydro plants, etc. And these are all renewable energies and will not reduce the CO2. So either we can use this renewable energies or reduce the power consumption. So here let me read the definition for green building. A green building is one which uses less water. Again, I think remember, as a mechanical, your responsibility to deal with the plumbing service also. Okay, so when you're designing a plumbing service, you must design the plumbing to reduce the water consumption. Next, optimize energy efficiency. This is your part as a HVAC engineer. You must reduce the power consumption by optimizing, means by making your system with maximum efficiency or designing your system with the maximum efficiency, or else conserve natural resources like renewable sources and generate less waste and provides healthier space for occupants as compared with the conventional building. Okay, so I think you got the idea about the green building. You see, LEED, point number 12, LEED, leadership in energy and environment designs a society deal with research and development for the green building. Again, belongs to US, and we have BLBC, local United Green Building Council. In India we have IGBC. Similarly, if you talk about Australia, they have Green Stars. So every country have their own society, and the major society dealing with the green building is LEED. And if you have 1 or 2 years experience, you can contact to this LEED people, and they will provide you some data to study. And after that, you can able to write the LEED certification exam. And once you get certify with the LEED, or once you get the LEED certification, that will add advantage in job, in resume, as well as in your job. With this, we did this chapter one, which is again the introduction part. And in this chapter one, you see, chapter one is also very important because it's very basic, and they may ask a definition of air conditioning, they may ask what is HVAC, or this application, or societies. These are very useful. Till then, we'll use the codes from ASHRAE, SMACNA, etc. So you must know abbreviation of all this. So Dimya has, what is ASHRAE? Or expand ASHRAE, or expand this SMACNA. So as an engineer dealing with the this MEP services, you must know all this. Apart from this, I'll provide you some more societies which is belongs to plumbing, firefighting and electrical, because yesterday we discussed if you're dealing with one service, you should know at least the basic of other services. So as a mechanical, you are supposed to deal with the HVAC, plumbing and firefighting, and you are also involved in electrical for coordination. And the electrical people also involved in mechanical services for coordination. So at this level, we are dealing with the HVAC service, but let me provide you the basic of the societies for other services. And it's not in the notes, please make a note. You can make a note online in class. IPC. IPC is International Plumbing Codes. For plumbing, we'll follow this IPC, internationally accepted International Plumbing Codes. For IPC, we have UPC. Next, you can write UPC. UPC is a Uniform Plumbing Codes. Make a note, NFPA. This is National Fire Protection Association. National Fire Protection Association. Next, for electrical, we have NEMA, NEMA. National Electrical Manufacturers Association. So with this, we conclude this chapter 1. Next, we'll deal with the chapter 2. This also very, very good. You see, chapter 1 and 2, to get the idea about this service. Very basic and very, very important. Especially this chapter 2. Because in chapter 2, you are going to learn the steps involved in designing what HVAC system, and the steps involved in installation, okay, and the steps involved in drafting, and the steps involved in estimation. You'll find in the estimation and drafting class. At this level, we are dealing with the designing and installation. So here, this chapter 2 will give you the idea about this HVAC service, okay, how this HVAC service means the steps in order for designing, and the steps involved in installation in order. And we'll also talk about the other services, because for coordination, because as I said, you cannot deal with only one service without coordination, okay, and we have an order for the services also. So you'll get the idea about this building services and how this initiate, and who is going to initialize this this project, okay. So very interesting and very important. So you consider this chapter 2 is like the overview of the entire training in this HVAC service. So first we'll talk about the designing, then we'll deal with the installation steps, okay. And so here you can read on screen chapter 2, project execute, first designing of the HVAC system. So you see that the project start from whom? Client means what? Is the owner. For a small project like window or split, we can call customer. But for big project, generally, technically it's a client. Client means the owner of the building or owner of the project. For example, what you do now, assume that you are the client. And you have enough space or land in commercial area. And you are willing to construct a 5-star hotel of say 10 floor, for example. So assume that you are the client and you are looking to construct a 5-star hotel in the commercial area. So to whom you are going to contact as a client? Architect. Why architect? And what is the difference between a civil engineer and an architect? Yes, online. If you talk about the civil engineer, in engineering, so you know, in engineering you'll find BE civil or BTech civil, right? In many universities the same. So if you talk about BE civil, or BTech civil, it's how many years? 4 years, right? But if you talk about BArch, is of 5 years. So the major difference between the BTech or BE civil and BArch, you see, BArch means the architect also basically belongs to the civil side. So they learn what the civil people are learning, plus they are also learning about the services. So you see, this is 5 years. Means they know the civil side, plus they know about the services. But it not mean that the architect can design the HVAC system, electrical system, firefighting. No, that will take care by mechanical and electrical people. But the architect can coordinate and provide the clearance for all the services, because the architect will learn the civil plus the services, means the architect can provide the clearance for services. For example, the same example. So you are the client now, and you are going to contact to architect. So architect will go for will deal with the overall planning of the building. Okay. For example, your requirement out of 10 floor, suppose ground door you want to leave for parking. Okay, this is a hotel project, for example, and the first floor is for reception area plus kitchen plus admin area plus for example employee rooms. Okay, this is not the hotel area except reception. Okay, and the actual hotel rooms start from second floor. So this is first floor and this is second floor, and from second 10th floor all hotel rooms, hotel area. And as a client, your requirement, central air conditioning from second floor to 10th floor, central air conditioning. And yesterday I think you remember, central air conditioning means we require the ducts. Okay, so you know ducts, yesterday the box, and you know the ducts maximum clearance compared to other services. So how the architect will plan, he will plan the height of the ground floor. This is one example to get the idea. The height of the ground floor, say 12 feet. Height of the first floor also say 12 feet. But from second floor to 10th floor, he will maintain minimum 14 to 16 feet height. For what? Because above the false ceiling, the ducts will run. So this is one example how the architect will plan the architect will do the overall planning of the building. Okay, apart from this, he will give the clearance to electrical services, mechanical services and other services. It means the architect will take care for overall planning of the building, not just the civil engineer. Civil engineer also involved in the construction side at the time of structure design, at the time of other designing, at the time of his construction. The civil engineer will take care, but the initialization of the project is done by whom? Architect. So architect is above all. So all the engineers, mechanical and electrical, all the services going to coordinate with the architect. Okay, because he know the services and he can able to coordinate with the mechanical, electrical services, and he will provide the clearance for designing this services. Okay, following online. But if he is a beginner, then means most of the time you'll face difficulty if you deal with the beginner cares, because means if they don't have the experience, it may create a lot of issues. So they may not provide the proper clearance, or because they are also learning. But if you talk about experienced architect, generally not find the issues. Okay, so he's an architect. So client, then the project initialization is done by architect based on the client or application requirement. One example I've given, like this we have number of example. At the time of learning you'll get the idea, don't worry. And the architect will care what he will do, the planning, and he will prepare the architectural layouts. But before this, do you know the difference between the architectural and structure? Yes, what is the difference? This online, the difference between architectural side and structural side. If you don't know, please make a note. Please make a note, online class. Architectural includes walls, comma, door, it means doors, comma, doors, and planning of spaces. I'll repeat. Is there in the notes? Is there? Is there? Okay, sorry. So you see, ready, you can verify online. You see, architecture includes wall, partitions, doors, windows, and planning of the spaces. Spaces means I'm talking about the rooms. Technically we'll call spaces, like bedroom is one space, drawing room is one space, similarly in office cabin is one space. So technically we used to call spaces, so planning of space. But when you talk about structural, you see, structural means which will bear the load of the building. And remember, wall itself is a load on the building. Wall will not bear the load. In RCC, we are dealing with the RCC structure only. The old construction is outdated. So if you talk about RCC construction, the wall is not a structure member. Wall is itself is a load on the building. Wall will not bear the load of the building. Okay, so that's the reason wall comes under architect, means architecture side. Structural includes what? Footing. Footing means the foundation of the building. Beams, column, and slab, which will bear the load of the building, load of the occupant, load of the appliances, plus load of mechanical and electrical equipments. This also is important. For example, on the top of the means on the roof, if you place a big machine called chiller, we'll discuss what is chiller, a air conditioning machine. So that is very heavy, like 700 kg or 800 kg or 1000 kg, etc. So in order to bear that load, the structure people must design the structure to bear that load. So remember, the structure includes footings, means beams, column, slab, which will bear the load of the occupants plus the appliance, plus the mechanical and electrical equipments. So this point again we'll discuss, don't worry. Next, so let me continue. So the client and the client requirement, as per the client requirement, the architect will initialize the project, okay, and he will prepare what? Architectural layouts. I'll show you one example of architectural layout, but we have a topic in chapter 6, and in chapter 6 at the building survey in detail we'll learn how to read the architectural layout. At this level, just let me open one small example, a smaller. So if you don't know how to read this architectural layout, don't worry. Before starting the design, we'll learn in detail how to read the architectural layout. Because if you cannot read the architectural layout, means you cannot think for planning of any service. So at this level, just I'm obvious to get the idea. So this is one example of architectural layout for a small villa, like men's majlis, dining room, kitchen, etc. So this is one example. Don't worry. So the architect will do the planning of like this, planning of this of the building, as per the client or application requirement. Okay, and after preparing this architect layout, the architect layout will send to different department to add what? Different services. And you see, I'm talking about designing only, I'm not talking about installation. Still we are talking about designing. So after preparing the architect layout, you see, firefighting designing, electrical designing, HVAC structure, etc. And the time of architectural structure also designed, but the final structure can be done after completing the services. Why, we'll discuss. But one question here, for example, if the architectural layout went to all this department, like to add all this or designing of all the services, can all the services start designing parallelly or simultaneously? Yes or no? You see, all the services is going to design and install for one building, na? Okay. So for example, at the same time, electrical people adding light fixture in the false ceiling here. And if this information not known by HVCP, they may add the diffuser also on the same location. So light fixture, you know. Do you know a diffuser? Okay. Quickly, I'll show you a diffuser. If you don't know, just you'll get the idea. Anyhow, we have a detailed topic at the time of A terminals selection. But here you see, you know this diffuser, which you'll find in the false ceiling, right? So this diffuser location is different from the light fixture location. Similarly, you'll find the sprinklers or the smoke detectors, heat detectors, etc. So all this is going to be in the fall ceiling. So if the designing of all the services is done parallelly, there may chances it the services or the services device may clash. Means again coordination issues. So that's the reason we are following the order of the service. We bother about HVC, but as I said now, without learning at least the basic of other service is difficult. So the first priority is given to the firefighting designing after preparing the architect layout as standard. You see, in different location, the order may vary, but as per standard, the first priority is given to firefighting designing. Why? Because we have two reasons. The first reason is firefighting service required approval from municipal, and for firefighting, you must follow the codes and standard from the municipal. For example, distance between the sprinkler, for example, most commonly 3 meters. So later, if you not get the clearance of 3 meter, and if you place more than 3 meters distance from the between the sprinkler, the municipal will not approve your design. Okay, so that is also one reason. And second reason is it's a safety service, so we'll provide the priority. But it not mean that complete service is done, then it will send to the service. First priority is given to firefighting, and after completing the firefighting designing, the architectural plus the firefighting service in that will take care by electrical in designing. And this, you see, this designing can be started parallelly, but the coordination side will follow this order. Okay, like arrangement of this light fixtures, diffusers, and sprinklers. So for that we'll follow the order. Okay, what mean that we'll wait till the completion of firefighting. Parallelly, electrical people can start finding the lux level, finding the total power, etc. Okay, so then electrical is second priority. Why not HVAC? Yesterday we learned HVAC is one of the major service. Then the second priority is we are providing it electrical. The reason is arrangement of light fixtures. Why? Because diffuser, if I place here, I can move to left side, right side, or 2 or 3 feet. It will not affect much to the distribution of air. But if you not arrange the light fixture uniformly, it will affect to the distribution of light. And remember, light arrangement or light is also one of the major major parameter or major for interior. Okay, suppose the interior design is totally very fine, but the lighting arrangement, the distribution of light is poor, then it will affect to the interior. And finally the client is looking for the good interior. So the light distribution, uniform distribution of light, also one of the major parameters for interior. So there is a reason arrangement of light priority is given to electrical, then HVAC. You can arrange the different other devices, but it not mean that we'll wait till the completion of electrical design. Parallelly, we start designing like load calculation and other. But when we talk about the arrangement and coordination with other services, we'll wait till the completion of arrangement of light fixtures, then only we can go for arrangement of diffusers or other A terminals. Then structure designing. Here you see structure initially with the architect will complete. For example, you see here you can find out the grid lines. This grid line along with the beams and column. Here is a column. So with the architect layout, you'll find the structure also. Then again, why it even structure designing? The final structure designing can be done after completing the services, considering the load of mechanical and electrical equipments. Because as I given the example, this big machine we are interested to place on the roof, so the roof slab must bear the load, na? Okay, so after completing the electrical mechanical service, and in the drawing we'll show the locations of machine. According to that, if required, the structure people will modify or finalize the structure design as per the load requirement. Okay. And finally, other consultants or other services like interior, furniture, carpet, etc. And remember, when we talk about designing, all the services or department we can call as consultants. So remember, consultant will take care for designing. Okay. And we talk about installation, we'll consider that as contractors. Okay. So we are talking about design, so these are all consultants. So it can be a big consultant having all the services, or it can be a separate consultant for mechanical, separate for electrical, separate for civil, etc. Depend. or it may be a big consultant offering all this with a different department in the same in the same roof. Okay, following online. Now we bother about HVAC. So in the notes you'll find the steps involved for HVAC designing. So first of all, basic theory, what I explained just now. So design of large project building project is an extremely complex task. Why? Because of coordination, because of all the services, and this all services design and install for one building. So it's not that much easy. If you talk about big project, okay, it may take months or even years to complete and may involve many engineers. And you see, months and year and involve many engineers means I'm talking about designing only, not installation. Even for designing, suppose a 10 floor building or a 30 floor building, it may take months to complete the designing only. And once the complete designing is done, then only the installation, the construction will start. Complete's not 100%. At the time of construction, you'll find a lot of changes, and on site you'll find changes and coordinate changes. But this design, this architectural structure and services designing is done, then the construction will start on site. Okay, so only for designing, you see, it will take years or months or even years and involve number of engineers, a team of architects and mechanical engineers, electrical engineers, draftsmen. So completely they are involving in designing only. So the design of, but if you talk about a private residence, you see, the design of a private residence is much simpler and may involve only one or two engineers. One engineer will take care for civil and architect side, and other is will take care for services for a small project like G+1 or a small office or a small villa, etc. Next, the design of HVAC system of large project is responsibility of whom? You see, HVAC consultant company. Consultant means will take care for designer. Next, consultant companies also carry out other duties such as cost estimation. Because after designing, before starting construction and the services, the client is interested to know the expected cost. Based on his budget only he can start the project. So the cost estimation also will take care by the consultant. Initial cost estimation, not the exact cost estimation. Definitely you'll find 10 to 50% this tolerance. So not exact, because exact costing can be done only after the final bills, after installation. But the estimate, rough estimate can calculate by the consultant. So cost estimation also done by, and for cost estimation metrics also required. Okay, and field supervision installation. So don't confuse with the points. Already we discussed the consultant will take care for design, and here it is written field supervision of installation. So it means they are also involved in site. Yes, they will involve on site, but partly, not completely, just to supervise the installation. For example, after completing the design by consultant, the design will take care by the contracting company and start the installation. Okay, and at the time of installation, any clarification, any issues or any changes, if won by this contracting company, they need to contact to the consultant, because consultant is responsible for design. So they will contact to the consultant. So that's the reason some engineers from the consultant side will also available on site with the contractor to supervise the installation, to clarify the dots. If any major changes, they will help. And because the responsibility of design is by consultant, so if any major changes done by the contractor and finally the parameters are not achieved, the responsibility, the design responsibility is on the consultant's shoulders. So for that reason also, to keep an eye on installation engineers or installation, you'll find engineers on site from the consultant only for supervision. So they will involve partly, not completely. Each of these tasks is performed in cooperation with the architect, already we discussed, who carry out the overall building planning and design. Okay. And next point. So next, coordination of work between the architect and other department is an important and difficult task. You know, an error in coordination will give you disaster results. For example, before reading the arrangement of electrical light fixtures, as a mechanical dealing with HVAC, if you complete the arrangement of A terminals, then your design or the arrangement of this diffusers and A terminals will not accept. If it is a big project, it's a lengthy task. Again, you have to rearrange. So this is one example. Similarly, so even the electrical people also, if they not wait for firefighting sprinklers and etc., if they complete the job, so redesigning, rearrangement is required. So waste of time, waste of energy. See, designing new project is easy compared with the modification in the project, the major modification in the project. Okay, so coordination is important. Next, the design of HV systems involve determining. So we are dealing with the HV service. So in this list, you'll find the steps involved in designing. Okay, so just I'll take 2 minutes to finish this today session. So here you see building survey, and at this level, just I'm going to read these points. And when you start the designing, each and every point is a separate chapter. Building survey is chapter 6. Selection of machine is nothing but classification of machine is chapter 5. Load calculation, one of the major and lengthy part, cooling and heating load calculation in manual plus software. And you'll find this in chapter 7. Machine selection, chapter 8. Duct designing, I'm considering this as a module 2. Then fan selection, water pipe sizing, fitting selection, pump selection, selection of type and some equipment, and finally planning the location of each piece of the equipment in the building. And this also cover in drafting part also. So at this level, just I'm giving the idea about the designing, and you must follow this sequence also. For example, without building survey, you cannot think for load calculation, and without load calculation, we cannot think for machine selection, and not select the machine, you'll not get the CFM, GPM, so you cannot deal with ducting and piping. So this must be in order. And if you talk about ducting, pipe means I'm talking chill water pipe. So chill water pipe is related to chill water system. Ducting is common for AHUs, for different system, etc. So as per the type of system also, you'll find change in the steps. For example, if you're dealing with the wind or split system, only load calculation, machine selection is done, no ducting, piping. Okay, similarly, if you're dealing with the package, we have list of system, we'll discuss, don't worry. So at this level, just this order is important, and this may ask in interview also. If they ask the steps involving HVC system designing for chill water system, you can able to read, initially you can read all these points in order. But don't worry, each and every topic, each and every point is a great chapter. In detail we'll discuss in the next classes. Okay, so this is just to get the idea about the designing. So how this designing, the sequence, who is responsible for initializing the project, who is the client, who is the architect, and how we are going to coordinate with other services as a mechanical, and means the order of the planning for the services and the steps involved in HVAC designing. Okay, so this topic is very important for mindset, to get the idea what we are going to learn in the next classes. Okay, so this is done for today's session. Anything to discuss online? Tomorrow I'll show you the steps involved in installing the HS system, and at the time installation also we need to follow the sequence for the different services, and who is responsible for installation and all, we'll discuss in detail in the next session. And we'll also talk about the types of drawing, like design drawing, shop drawing, etc. Okay, so done for today's session.